This lesson is designed to help you get things done quickly and consistently by using shortcuts in Microsoft Excel 2010. We will start with a short discussion on shortcuts generally. After that, we will see some ways that you can easily learn shortcuts while you use Excel, which is mainly through the keytip badges that appear after we press Alt or F10, and the screen tips that appear when we hover the mouse pointer over a button. Next, we will learn to navigate menus and dialog boxes by using shortcuts that are common across the Microsoft products. We will finish by going through some of my favorite shortcuts. This will include shortcuts that I haven't noticed being indicated by the visual cues in Excel. You wouldn't know that they exist unless you looked them up or you were told about them. There will also be a number of shortcuts that you would hope to eventually pick up on your own, using the tools that we will discuss. We will also go through some tips and tricks that are not actually shortcuts, but do fit in with the general theme of getting things done quickly and consistently. This is a long lesson. Check the video description if you're looking for something in particular. There are start times listed for the various sections. Rather than trying to memorize a lot of shortcuts at once, I suggest that you pause the video to try each one as we go, and then just move on. That way, you will know that these shortcuts exist, and you can look them up as they become relevant to you. A lot of shortcuts from previous versions of Excel still work, but we will not go through them here, because I think that they are relatively difficult to learn without the prompts. If you already know them, then by all means keep using them. Let's get started. When we start using Excel, it is common to use the mouse a lot. That's fine, and in fact for a lot of tasks, the mouse is the tool of choice, even for advanced users. However, after a bit of practice, using the keyboard is usually quicker and more reliable. Many actions take fewer steps on the keyboard than they would with the mouse. Tasks become so easy with the keyboard that we notice the small inconvenience of having to reach for the mouse, locate the mouse pointer on the screen, and move it to the thing that we want to click on. Shortcuts are reliable. If you do have problems, which is unusually likely today, as we try a bunch of shortcuts for the first time, the most common issues that I see are third-party add-ins using shortcuts which may override the Excel defaults, macros with shortcuts assigned to them, which, again, might override the Excel defaults, and differences between keyboards, language settings, and versions of Excel. For add-ins, there may be a way to change or turn off the conflicting shortcut, and it may be obvious, or you may need to contact the supplier. You may also have the option of removing the add-in. If this is causing a problem for you, it's likely that you will already know what the add-ins are, or at least your IT department or another person using the computer should know. For macros, you may be able to reassign or remove associated shortcuts. The easiest way is often through the macro dialog box, which can be found in the ribbon under View, Macros. I've got a macro which overrides the shortcut Ctrl+S in this workbook. Normally Ctrl+S would save the active workbook, just like clicking the Save button in the Quick Access toolbar or from the Backstage menu. But here, when I press Ctrl+S, some words are entered in the active cell. That's annoying. Let's stop it. The offending macro is already selected, so we click Options. A lowercase letter in this field makes a shortcut Ctrl and that letter. An uppercase letter makes a shortcut Ctrl, Shift and that letter. I don't want any shortcut assigned to this macro, so I will clear the field. Now Ctrl+S saves the workbook. For language, I'm using a US English keyboard. The language for my operating system is set to US English, and all the shortcuts seem to be working. If you have problems, check that your language settings match your keyboard. Some shortcuts use keys with symbols on them. For example, Ctrl+Shift+3 will change the number format to date. I will say that shortcut as Ctrl+Shift+3, and it will be written as shown on the screen, with the hash or pound symbol in brackets. The hash symbol is on the upper half of the 3 key on my keyboard. If it is somewhere else on your keyboard, and Ctrl-Shift-3 is not working, try that other key. Control, Shift, and your key with the hash symbol. If the hash symbol is on the lower half of the key, try it without the shift. Control, and your key with the hash symbol. It's possible that you might find a shortcut which is unavailable in your language version of Excel. We can use access keys to access the commands on the Quick Access toolbar or the ribbon. Press the Alt key or the F10 key, and keytip badges appear. These tell us what the access keys are. F for File, H for Home, and so on. I'll press H for the Home tab. Now keytips for the Home tab are shown. Let's press X for Cut. That cut the selection, so Alt, H, X is a shortcut for cut. For the remainder of this video, I will use and mention the Alt key for access key shortcuts, but you might choose to use the F10 key instead. It's purely down to personal preference. I suggest you practice using access key shortcuts a few times now. Later, as you continue to use Excel, try pressing Alt anytime you feel inconvenienced by using the mouse for the ribbon. That way, you will naturally memorize many of the access key shortcuts that are most useful for you. If you customize the Quick Access toolbar or the ribbon, the access keys will be customized accordingly. Now, Alt-4 is an access key to decrease the font size. Once we know the access key shortcuts, we can press them quickly. We don't have to wait for the keytip badges to appear. There are other shortcuts which are unrelated to the Quick Access toolbar or the ribbon. Some of these you need to look up or be told about, which may sound difficult, but actually the shortcut keys tend to be related to the actions that they perform, and are often common across programs, so it can be easy. Also, Excel includes many screen tips, which appear when we hover the mouse pointer over buttons. Screen tips contain information on the item, sometimes including a shortcut. Let's see some examples. This screen tip shows that a shortcut for cut is Ctrl-X, which means that we hold down the Ctrl key and press X, then release both. We saw earlier through keytips that another shortcut for cut is Alt-H-X. Either will work. Not all screen tips mention shortcuts. There are shortcuts listed for some drop-down items. There is no shortcut mentioned for the main delete button, but there is a shortcut for the delete cells button in the dropdown. I suggest you practice checking for a few screen tips now, and then in the future, use them to learn shortcuts while you continue to use Excel. If you wonder whether there's a shortcut, navigate to the button as you normally would, and hover the mouse over it for a few moments to see if a screen tip with a shortcut appears. The navigation keys are more powerful than they initially appear. In Excel, the main navigation keys are the arrow keys, page up and page down, home, and end. Tab and enter can also be used for navigation. When Excel is in the ready state, the arrow keys will move the active cell by one cell at a time. Page up and page down will move the active cell by one screen at a time. And home will move the active cell to the beginning of the row. The modifier keys change the actions of the other keys. When we hold down the control key, the arrow keys will move the active cell to the edge of the current data region. There is not much information in this worksheet, so the data regions are mainly going to end at the edges of the worksheet. Holding Ctrl while pressing Page Up or Page Down will change the worksheet selected. Control with Home or End will move the active cell to the beginning or end of the used range in the worksheet. Holding down the Shift key while using the navigation keys will generally extend the selection. Here's Shift with the arrow keys. Shift with Page Up and Page Down. And Shift with Home. Alt is short for Alternative. This modifier generally triggers a related action. Alt and Page Down moves the active cell one screen to the right rather than one screen down. The modifiers can often be used in combination. We saw that Control Home will move the active cell to the beginning of the worksheet, and that holding Shift while using the navigation keys tends to extend the selection. So it's not too surprising that pressing Control Shift Home extends the selection to the beginning of the worksheet. We can cycle through the selection using the Tab and Enter keys. Tab moves the active cell right. Enter moves the active cell down. Holding Shift while pressing either Tab or Enter will reverse the direction. We can navigate within the text of an entry when XL is in Edit mode. The status bar tells us if XL is in Edit mode. Right now it is not. We can usually access Edit mode by clicking in the formula bar. Now XL is in Edit mode, and the arrow keys move the cursor one character at a time. Home and End move to the start and end of the line. Holding Shift while pressing the arrow keys extends the selection. And holding Control while pressing the arrow keys moves one word at a time. We can navigate menus and dialog boxes using the keyboard. The active item is highlighted in some way that is usually quite subtle. For dialog boxes, that highlighting is often a dotted line. Pressing the Tab key will cycle forward through fields. Holding Shift while pressing Tab will cycle backwards. Holding Control while pressing Tab will cycle forward through tabs. Holding Control and Shift while pressing Tab will cycle backwards through the tabs. When the active item is a checkbox or an option, we can press Space to toggle it or select it. When the active item is a field with options, we can change the selection with the arrow keys. We can often press Enter instead of using the left mouse button. There is usually different highlighting to indicate the command assigned to Enter. Right now, pressing Enter is equivalent to clicking on the color that we have navigated to. Now, OK is highlighted, and pressing Enter is equivalent to clicking OK. Where labels include an underlined letter, we can select the option or perform the action by holding Alt and pressing that letter. The S in size is underlined, so Alt S will select that option. The B in subscript is underlined, so pressing Alt B will toggle that option. We can usually press the Escape key in place of clicking on Cancel. If we press the Escape key now, our changes will be cancelled and the dialog box will close. The Escape key can generally be used to cancel out of things. Other examples include formula edits and selection of objects. These navigation shortcuts transfer over to most menus. Watch the button for the Home tab as I press the Alt key. As well as the keytips appearing, the Home button gains some subtle highlighting. As before, we can use Tab to move around and Enter in place of the mouse button. We can also use the arrow keys to navigate the ribbon. Excel includes a number of context menus, which are normally associated with the right mouse button. The options available from these context menus depend on the context. For example, when we press the right mouse button on a cell while in Ready mode, the context menu includes options to cut, copy, insert, and delete. If we press the right mouse button on a cell while in cut copy mode, the context menu also includes paste options. We can access the context menu by pressing the menu or application key, or by pressing Shift F10. For the remainder of this video, I will use and mention the menu key to open the context menu. It only tends to be reliably available on full-size Windows-oriented keyboards, but you might use Shift F10 instead. The set of shortcuts that we are about to go through are fairly common across computer programs in general. Control A for All. In Excel, this selects all the cells in the current region. Pressing Control A again will select all the cells in the active sheet. If Excel doesn't recognize a current region, it will go straight to the entire sheet. We can also select all the cells in the active workbook by clicking on the Select All button. Control left for Find. This brings up the Find tab of the Find and Replace dialog box. Find is available through the ribbon. There are access keys that work, and a screen tip that reminds us of Control F. Control G for Go To. This brings up the Go To dialog box, which is useful for quickly navigating large workbooks. We can type any location into this field to go there. This field contains a list of recent locations that we can quickly select. Special takes us to the Go To Special dialog box, which contains more advanced options that are also useful. Notice that each description contains an underlined letter, so they can be accessed from the keyboard. This is in the ribbon, and there is a screen tip. We can also access the Go-To dialog box by pressing F5. Control H for Replace. This brings up the Replace tab of the Find and Replace dialog box. This is also in the ribbon, and there is a screen tip. Control N for New. This creates a new blank workbook. Control O to Open. The Open dialog box allows us to open an existing workbook. Control P for Print. We can set print options from this menu and print by clicking on this button. Control S to Save. This saves the current workbook over the file it was opened from. The new file will be in the same location as the original file, it will have the same file name, and be the same file type. This is in the default Quick Access toolbar, and there is a screen tip. F12 for Save As. This brings up the Save As dialog box. Control X to cut. I suspect that X is used, both because it looks a bit like a pair of scissors, and also because it is next to C, which we're about to look at. There's a screen tip. Control C to copy. There's a screen tip. Control V to paste. Screen tip. We can also paste by pressing Enter. Enter is slightly different to paste, because Enter also takes Excel out of cut copy mode. We can copy once, and then we have the choice to paste multiple times with Control V, or once with Enter. Control Z for undo. This will usually undo the last action, and we can often undo multiple actions. Some things interrupt the undo stack, meaning that we lose the ability to undo. Common examples are saving, including autosaves, most macros, and deleting sheets. Undo is in the default Quick Access toolbar, and there's a screen tip. Control Y to redo or repeat. Redo is the opposite of undo. Repeat means to repeat the last action. F4 usually works as well. Control Tab will cycle through the tabs in a window. We already saw this when cycling through the tabs of a dialog box. When Excel is in ready mode, and there are multiple workbooks open, Control Tab will cycle through the open workbooks. F1 brings up the Help window. There's a screen tip for this. F7 runs a spell check. This is in the ribbon, and there is a screen tip. Either Control F4 or Control W will close the current document, which in the case of Excel is the active workbook. Alt F4 closes the program. It closes Excel. When we are entering functions in a formula, a list of function names starting with the letters that we have entered appears. We can select the relevant function with the up and down arrow keys, then press Tab to include it in the formula. When we are entering a formula, and it makes sense to include or update a reference, we can do so with the arrow keys or the mouse. The functionality is the same as when we are changing the selection. Rather than double-clicking a cell, or clicking in the formula bar to edit an entry, we can press F2. F2 toggles Edit and Enter modes. In Edit mode, the arrow keys allow us to navigate within the entry. In Enter mode, when the cursor is in a location that makes sense to include or update a reference, the arrow keys or mouse will engage point mode. When entering or editing cell references and range references, we can cycle through the absolute and relative options by pressing F4. You don't need to actively do anything, for example, click on this tick to commit an entry. Changing the active cell will do. Control Enter to fill the selection with the current entry. This means that the formula you enter will be applied to all the cells in the selection. This takes relative references into account. It works as if the entry is made into the active cell and then copied into the rest of the selection. You may have noticed that I've been committing entries by pressing Control Enter when only one cell has been selected. This is similar to pressing Enter, but it does not move the active cell regardless of your settings. With the default settings, the active cell will move down when you press Enter. Control Shift Enter to apply an array formula. This is actually the only native way to enter an array formula in Excel. I plan to go through array formulas in another video. Control D to fill down. This copies from the top row of the selection to all cells in the selection. Control R to fill right. This copies from the left column of the selection to all the cells in the selection. Alt equals for autosum. There's a screen tip for this. Alt Enter can be used to include a line break within an entry. This works within formulas and text entries. Control Grave Accent to toggle the Show Formulas option. When the Show Formulas option is selected, we see all the formulas in their cells instead of their calculated results. I plan to cover the tools available under Paste Special in another video. For this section, I will assume that you know what they are and focus on the different ways that they can be activated. Assuming we are in Cut Copy mode with something copied, we can access the Paste Special options in different ways. Through the ribbon, under Home, Paste, Paste Special. This brings up the full Paste Special dialog box with all the options. Using the keyboard, we can paste values, for example, with Alt to access the ribbon, H for the Home tab, V for Paste, S for Paste Special, V for Values, and Enter to confirm. Alt, H, V, S, V, Enter. Or, through the ribbon more directly, under Home, Paste. Common options are available here. We can paste values this way with Alt to access the ribbon, H for the Home tab, V for Paste, V for Values. Alt, H, V, V. Through the context menu, under Paste Special, Paste Special. This brings up the full Paste Special dialog box. We can paste values this way with Menu to access the context menu, S for Paste Special, S for Paste Special, V for Values, Enter to confirm. Menu, S, S, V, Enter. Through the context menu more directly, under Paste Special, common options are available here. Menu to access the context menu, S for Paste Special, V for Values. Menu, S, V. Even more directly in the parent context menu. A smaller set of options are available here. Menu to access the context menu, V for values. Menu, V. Through the paste menu after pasting. Common options are available here. Using the keyboard, we can paste values this way by pressing Ctrl V to paste, followed by Ctrl for the paste options menu, and V for paste values. Ctrl V, Ctrl V. We can press F3 for the paste name dialog box. All the easily available to find names appear on this list. The workbook I have open contains two names, both scoped to the workbook and both available here. If we select a name and press OK, a reference to that name will be included in the active cell. When working on a formula, there are no other options. If we press F3 while Excel is in ready mode, the dialog box also contains this print list button. This button will include a list of all the names along with their formulas. If no names are available, there will be a ding sound when you press F3, and nothing else will happen. We can extend the selection to include entire rows by pressing Shift, Space. This is equivalent to clicking on the row header. We can extend the selection to include entire columns by pressing Ctrl Space. This is equivalent to clicking on the column header. We can insert cells with Ctrl Shift Equals. There's a screen tip for this. It may be easier to remember as Ctrl Plus. If we copy before inserting cells, the inserted cells include a copy. We can insert rows through the ribbon, and we could press Alt, then follow the keytip badges to find the access keys for that. Alternatively, we can select entire rows and then insert cells. This skips the Insert dialog box and automatically shifts cells down, which is the only option that would make sense. Putting the two shortcuts together, it's Shift Space, Ctrl Shift Equals. Again, if we copy before inserting cells this way, the inserted cells include a copy. Copy. Insert cells. We can insert columns the same way. Ctrl Space to select the entire column. Ctrl Shift Equals to insert cells.
We can delete cells with Ctrl minus. There's a screen tip for this. If we select entire rows first, this will automatically delete the rows without showing the delete dialog box. Putting the two shortcuts together, it's Shift Space, Ctrl minus. We can delete columns the same way. Ctrl space to select the column. Ctrl minus to delete. We can insert a new worksheet through the ribbon or by clicking on this button. Either way, we can hover to see a screen tip which mentions the shortcut Shift F11 to do the same thing. We can copy a worksheet by holding Ctrl while dragging the sheet tab. Notice that the cursor includes a small plus symbol within the image of the sheet while the control key is being pressed. We can include a group by pressing Shift, Alt, Right arrow. There's a screen tip for this. If we select entire rows before grouping, Excel will automatically group those rows because that's the only option that makes sense. Shift space to select the entire row. Shift Alt right arrow to group. If we select entire columns before grouping, Excel will automatically group those columns. Control space to select the column. Shift Alt right arrow to group. We can remove a group with Shift Alt left arrow. If we select entire rows first, this will directly ungroup rows. Likewise for columns. We can select the precedence of the cells in the selection by pressing Ctrl open square bracket. Precedence are the cells that a formula references. Right now, cell E8 is selected, and we can see that the precedence are E7 and G5. Ctrl open square bracket will take us to E7 and G5. Now cells E7 and G5 are selected, and we can see that the precedents of E7 are C5 to F5, and the precedents of G5 are G2 to G4. Pressing Ctrl open square bracket again will take us to C5 to F5 and G2 to G4. We looked at the Go To dialog box earlier. Notice what happens when we access it now. The reference field is pre-populated with the cells that we just came from, so we can simply confirm to go back to them. This combination of shortcuts is regularly used when trying to understand or check formulas. We can quickly see that this cell shows the sum of numbers in some other cells. Ctrl open square bracket to select precedence. So it's the sum of these cells in particular. F5, then Enter to go back. Next, we might want to look at this cell. This is a sum as well. Select precedence to see which cells, and go back. This formula works differently when not all the precedents are on the same worksheet as you start on. We can select dependents by pressing Ctrl, close square bracket. Dependents are the opposite of precedents. We can select all dependents by pressing Ctrl, Shift, close square bracket. These commands are limited to dependents on the same sheet. We can access a drop-down menu in the active cell by pressing Alt, down arrow. This works just as you would expect for cells with data validation or filters. We can sometimes open a drop-down menu when it isn't apparent that one exists. Excel has provided a list of values in nearby cells. This can be useful when entering data. F11 to chart the selection in a new sheet. This is commonly used to quickly check for trends or anomalies, and often we want to delete the chart after looking at it. There are access keys to delete a worksheet. Notice that deleting a worksheet interrupts the undo stack. We can't undo deleting a worksheet. We're about to look at some common formatting shortcuts. You should notice that we see different options for some commands, and that they basically fall into sets. I suggest that you look at them all, and then focus on the ones that seem easiest and most useful for you. We can access the Format Cells dialog box by clicking on any of these buttons. The buttons are actually slightly different. This one takes us to the Number tab of the Format Cells dialog box. This one takes us to the Alignment tab. And this one takes us to the Font tab. We can also access the Font tab by pressing Ctrl, Shift, F. Alternatively, we can access the dialog box by pressing Ctrl 1. This takes us to the tab that was opened most recently. We can toggle bold formatting in the selection by pressing Ctrl 2. Ctrl B also works. Ctrl 3 to toggle italics. Ctrl I works as well. Ctrl 4 for underline. Ctrl U also works. And Ctrl 5 for strike through. We can set the selection to the general number format by pressing Ctrl, Shift, Grave Accent. Remember, I'm using a US English keyboard layout. The shortcut includes Shift, Grave Accent, and the tilde symbol is on the upper half of the Grave Accent key. So that part of the shortcut can be thought of as tilde, and the shortcut is effectively Ctrl tilde. If you have a different keyboard layout and Ctrl Shift tilde is not working for you, try Ctrl tilde, and include Shift if your tilde is on the upper half of a key. We can set the selection to the number format by pressing Ctrl Shift 1. This is effectively Ctrl exclamation mark. Ctrl Shift 2 for the time number format. This is effectively Ctrl at. Ctrl Shift 3 or Ctrl hash for the date number format. Ctrl Shift 4 or Ctrl dollars for the currency number format. Ctrl Shift 5 or Ctrl percent for the percent number format. Ctrl Shift 6 or Ctrl caret for the scientific number format. You may be able to scroll using the scroll wheel of your mouse. Roll the scroll wheel towards yourself to scroll down the page a few rows at a time. and roll it away from you to scroll up the page. You might be able to pan with the scroll wheel. Click the scroll wheel button and an origin mark may appear. Move the pointer in the direction that you want to scroll, and move further to scroll faster. If that works, you can probably also pan by clicking and holding the scroll wheel button. This works the same way, but it will stop when you release the wheel button. You can hold down the control key and roll the scroll wheel to change the zoom level. Hover the mouse over the ribbon and roll the scroll wheel to change tabs. We've covered a lot. As I mentioned earlier, I think that the best way to learn shortcuts is to first be told that they exist, and then practice the ones that are useful and relevant whenever that may be. Let's quickly recap some ways that you can find a shortcut. Press the Alt key and check for keytip badges to access items on the ribbon. Hover over buttons to check for screentip information, which may include shortcuts. The action may be available through the context menu, which you can access through the menu or application key, or by pressing Shift F10. You can also check the Excel help menu. And assuming that you have an internet connection, you can search online for shortcuts. If you really want to master all of this stuff, it might be worthwhile re-watching this video a few months from now. My YouTube channel includes some more videos teaching Excel. Feel free to click that like button if you found this helpful, leave a comment if there is a particular area that you're interested in, and subscribe to be notified when new videos are available.